Hello there, and welcome to episode 14 of The Rise of Vowles, with me, Darth Ravon Gaming. Belgium, Spa Francorchamps. So, our goal is to maintain 5th, or at the very least maintain 6th, in the Drivers' Championship, not Drivers' Championship, Constructors' Championship. We're going to go in here with a strategy of doing soft, medium, soft, and looking after those soft tyres. Stay off the curbs. And stay with the cars in front. So, let's load a setup quickly. According to my cheat app. Correct me if I'm wrong, is Belgium not a sprint? It is. Belgium is a sprint. So we are going straight on the hard tyres with this setup and maximising our options. So, car setup. I was expecting more cornering required, really. Quick pre-session save.
That's green now. Green now.
After the car.
We okay on temperatures?
The tires are a bit on the cool side, so just watch out.
Let's heat those tires up a bit. Ruby, be quiet. Come here.
Was there damage?
Yeah, we are about to give it a square. Thank you. So, after 8 laps, we are looking at 10% loss on the tyres for hards. That's acceptable. He's saying great, so... I think we use.
All okay with the car?
Everything's pretty stable. Nice one, guys.
Understood.
Considering that we've got grey, I think we leave it. We'll leave them out on the hards. End of this lap, we throw some softs on. Okay. All right, we just do that. So, Albono had good, great, 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 and good. Maybe I can change that to that, that to that. See, I don't agree. I think we just plain change to that. I think that's fine. Tires, softs, and whereas Danny, ooh. Oversteer is optimal, braking optimal, cornering great, traction great, and straights are optimal. See, I'm not feeling that. I feel like you would have higher cornering. Okay. Give me three from Albono, come on. Let me have two from Danny Rick. Three from Albono. Let's have two from Danny Rick. Two from Danny Rick, come on. Maybe, if I'm lucky. Max is taking a penalty. Should really have left Danny Rick where he was, to be honest. I just sent him out again. Here we are now at qualifying. Okay, so back to Albono. I think that's what we do. We'll give him that setup. Okay. Definitely going to be sweating a bit on engine here. As far as Danny Rick is concerned, let's look at that setup. Optimal, optimal. I think we don't need to worry with Danny Rick. I think his setup's perfect. Okay, so we'll save that.
To push on with the tyres.
Yep, copy.
This is the point where we really, really don't want anyone coming out of the pits. I would say we are now safe. Not going to be coming up behind De Vries here, hopefully. He is very slow though, is De Vries. That's going to cost definitely Albon.
there's a yellow flag now.
I mean, theoretically, we should be the fastest car around most of this track. But the fact that we've got... Sights on in lap. Okay, so the houses aren't going to beat us. Sights is on the in lap, so he's not going out again, neither is De Vries. I think we can risk this. That's a lot of cars on outlaps. I think we'll be okay. Yep. Which suggests to me we nailed the setup. Did I only bet one? No, I didn't. I bet both cars on Q3. That sounds like a good move. And both cars are on 100% for setup. That's great. So. Let's. I think we can chance it with the old tyres on this one. Why are all these tyres locked? It's weird. Okay. Oh, it's only a 94. Interesting. I mean, it'll do though. Quick pre-session save. I think we might have been saved by having put the newer engines in. But let's go. Q2. Straight out the pits. No sign of rain. So avoid high risk curbs straight away. And straight to yellow for tyres. And the same for Danny Rick. I want to slow down very, very slightly. Avoid the high-risk curbs. Off you go, boys. Oh, Russell's going to be in the way. Up Eau Rouge, no less. Oh, no, actually, even worse. Get out of the way, George. Get out of the way. Get out of the way. Get out of the way. He's got out of the way of Albon, but has he got out of the way of Danny Rick? No. He's very much in Danny Rick's way. Fantastic. God, he lost so much time. Donny Rick's definitely going to have to go again. Look after the engine on your way in.
And here we've got a yellow flag.
Okay, that's fine. New set of tyres, and what? Still supposedly don't lose any time. That's mad. So the short of it is that Albono is quick. Oh no. Donny Rick's lost a load of time again. Loads of time. Should have sent him out with more fuel in. And he's still gone out anyway. That's a poor move. Really poor move on my part. Right, okay.
Ruby, will you be quiet?
Control.
Good stops to build temperature.
Yep, copy.
And avoid the high risk, please, buddy. So we're very much going to be going straight into traffic here. Certainly going to be coming up by the back of Stroll. Not lost too much time, I don't think. I mean, we have. We've lost loads. I think we use these tyres again and go again. Oh, I left Irish curbs on. Whoops. Still lost half a second on that. Right, big push now, mate. Big push now. Here we go. Clean lap. Off you go, Albono. Let's see what you can do. What are you capable of? That's a good lap, that. Right, look after your tyres, just in case you need them again later. Session save. Off we go. Oh wait. Let's not do that. Let's change the car parts out. Not use the stuff for the race. Thing is, Danny Rick's got a very quick car for the race, so I'm not too worried about that. Should be able to gain some decent positionage. See how many laps we can throw on these tyres. So, percent of the tyres. Albono's still not even got them to full temp, which is mad. What is interesting is though, running at this pace, 25 laps, is about as much as these tyres will do. I started at 80%. So I've got 50% wear over 20 laps. The mediums are going to be much better. Save a set of softs for the race. So it's 20 laps on the softs. Let's try run these on aggressive. So we are talking 10 laps, we lose 20%.
Not sure if I've got damage.
That's fine. That would be checkered flag.
Okay. Massive confidence boost for the drivers. Great. Into the sprint, let's go. How many laps is the sprint race? 15 laps, it's soft tyres. You're wrong, it's soft tyres. And it's full push all the way. That's interesting. Right, so what have we got tyre wise? Got two mediums and three softs. I think it's softs. Thank you. And I think we overfuel by a lap, and I think we absolutely gun it. As if Albon's starting in third.
Overtake if required.
You have to go the big.
Copy.
There you go, big push, boys, big push. What's going on with... Oh, no.
Always focus, focus and push.
Okay. I'm not having that. I'm going to cheat. Mistakes were made. Because guess what I forgot to do? No wonder both cars are struggling off the line. Okay.
Here we are, the sprint around
Spa. Oh, look, they're all on softs now. Full push, boys, full push. Off you go. Danny Rick's already up to 11th. Mental. Right, so we're really interested in how quickly everyone's tyres will degrade versus ours. And the simple fact is, it is faster. What we're looking for is staying within the DRS of that Ferrari and not losing our tyres too much. We're not staying in the DRS of that Ferrari. is the simple. At some point, some of these guys will go into a tyre management phase. Whereas I believe we won't have to. I'm not really very worried about Albono right now. Oh, here goes Danny Rick. He hasn't got the legs on that Alpine. Can he do it out of here? Simply no. He's lost a load of ground. Albono's beasting it. Come on, Danny Rick. Skin him. So slow out of the source. Danny Rick just dropped DRS. Yeah, he has. So Magnussen can get nowhere near Albono. So basically we're aiming at looking after these tyres until probably about 5 laps from the end. And then absolutely skin them. Gasly's eating his tyres these last few laps.
We're on tyre management.
Okay, understood.
Come on, mate, get round him.
Okay, understood.
Hamilton just blocks him off. And that's Alonso going to skin him. Oh. Right, we'll just harvest for a lap. Albono's dropped to fifth. And that's fine. Achieve here. We're just so slow out of that last corner. Off you go, Danny Rick. It's time to go. Oh, yes. Skin him. That's the stuff. Now take Alonso as well. Oh, Alonso just being Alonso, unfortunately. Right, so back to watch your tyres. And harvest for now. What's Danny Rick got off his sleeve here? High risk overtake, I think, is the way to go. Push it, Danny Rick. Down the inside. Let's go, mate. Come on. Or do nothing. What can he do here, Alonso? Stick it up the outside of him. Go on. Round the outside. Wow. At Puon. Round the outside at Puon. High risk overtake. Oh no, let's go. Go on, Danny Rick. Let's have Alonso. You've got him. Yes, lad. Go on, Albono! Get in! Oh, so close.
That's the flag.
And it's a win today for Lance Stroll.
So Danny Rick climbs to 8th. Come on, come here. Or don't. All right then. Okay. So that's an interesting point that we can do 15 laps at full pace on avoid high risk curbs. So full race is 44 laps. Can we do a soft to medium? Is that a thing? I think we do. I think we do a soft medium. Oh no, compound locked. Yeah, I think we're going to do it. I think we're going to do soft medium. Right. Danny Rick starts in P6. Do you know what? I think we go secret option C. Medium, soft. Knowing that we're going to have to overcut ourselves. We change this to a medium, soft. Oh, actually, is a medium, soft quicker? Medium, soft is faster. Let's do Danny Ricks as a medium, soft. And then we'll have Albono Strat. Strat A is a medium soft. Strat B is a medium soft. Strat D is a medium soft. Surely medium soft is the way to go though. Okay, let's do it as that, and then we can aim for a medium soft if we want later. Gives us more options for a safety car.
Get ready, it's the Belgian Grand Prix. And it's lights out, and away we go.
Avoid the high risk curbs. Avoid the high-risk curbs and ERS battle assist, please.
Overtake is available if needed.
Okay.
There's an opportunity for some rather serious points here for both cars. Johnny Rick to pick the pace up here. Let's have a look at this one stop. He is on target for that one stop. Right, that's Alvono losing a position. What's interesting is LeGreg doesn't appear to be getting away. Use each other, boys, come on. Come on, Albano, catchy catchy. What have we got? Sector 2? Well, that's right at the end of Sector 1, is it? Safety car. Are we coming in? No, I don't think we are. This actually opens us up to a one stop. Anyone running soft surely must be coming in.
Safety car, safety car.
Red?
Stay close to the delta.
Damn.
Keep working your brakes.
Okay. I think Albano runs softs here.
Red flag.
Here we go once more. The track is ready. And so are the drivers. And it's lights out, and away we go.
Push.
Yep, copy.
So Alonso's gone to hards, and clearly fans are running to the end.
There's a yellow flag now.
Aston Martin's quick. And you avoid the high rage skills, mate. If you're gonna go, you're gonna go, but.
That's a red flag.
Another red flag.
Right, let's follow the action now at turn 7.
I think we throw Albono on the softs again. This time we throw Danny Rick on the softs as well. Let's get some track position.
Once more, they're ready to race. And it's lights out, and away we go.
So we are the only cars on softs. How would you lose a position?
Come down, mate. You're good.
Skin him down the inside. Come on, do it. Oh. So we are currently sat massively, massively over on fuel. High risk overtake, Danny Rick, come on, do it. Stay off the high risk curbs then. Oh, yes, you did, mate. That's the stuff. Don't be another red. Oh, Danny Rick, you legend. Right, look after your tyres. What just happened?
There's been a crash.
That's the top two. Was that Stroll going in the back of Verstappen? It was. That was Stroll rear-ending Verstappen.
Positive on the Delta.
Yeah, copy.
Oh, it wasn't Verstappen, it was Perez, but anyway. This actually helps the cars behind us a little bit. We don't actually need to save fuel here, I don't know why I've done that. Right, we need to just gun it now.
Maximum pace now. Okay.
Make sure you use some energy.
Yep.
And here we've got a yellow flag.
Keep the temps down, boys. Keep the temps down. What is the it's 8 seconds under a VSC. So if we get another VSC, we've got to pit. Right, look after your tyres now, mate. That looks like a rather exceptional move. Pitting for softs there. But let's see. Magnussen lock up again. Albano's on fire. Question is, can we pull 16 seconds back if we pit? Thing is, I think these tyres will go to the end if we drop the pace a little. But dropping the pace means Alonso takes us. And I don't really want to do that. Alonso's jumping at the DRS now. Could really do with a VSC. A VSC would do me rather nicely right now. Albono's got to. Okay, let's take away the high risk curbs. They both need to push. If we get a VSC, this is massive. If we don't, it's a problem. Direct to bring his temps down. Where's the Toledo? We could do with getting Gasly here. Yeah, I know, mate, I know. We got a neutral there. We both can avoid high-risk curbs. Now we are. Okay, Danny Rick's dropping. Slight drop of pace now, Danny Rick, I'm afraid. I think Albono comes in now for a set of mediums and shoves it good and proper. Goes one more lap. That's fine.
Okay, box, box.
And to be honest, Danny Rick probably can too. Go hard, mate, go hard.
Box, box.
Box, go hard.
Absolute perfection from the Williams team. Absolute perfection. Let's remove the high risk curb option because we just don't need it. Oh god, the rate they are catching Alonso. It's disgusting. So 12-2 across the line for Albono there with 10 laps to go. So Alonso's straight line speed is higher. What are we capable of here? Through the corners, it's just something else. Wow. Okay. I don't think we're going to catch for the lead here. Danny Rick, remove our virus curve option. And go straight full deploy. And it's the same for you, Albono. Time to go, mate. looking for fastest lap from Albono now. Or fast lap from Gasly, right? Not Gasly, Ricciardo. Albono pulling a second this lap. Do. I need you to watch your tyres, mate. Just bring them down for a lap. Factor no longer avoid high risk curbs. Okay, we're down to 9 seconds out of the final corner. That's with some tyre management. Still a little bit more tyre management, I think, is the way to go. Just a little low. Let's have a big shove it around the side of him, mate. Come on. Max might be a problem for Albono now. Has Albono just done Max around the outside? He has. Albono has just done Max around the outside. Drop your tyre temps for a bit. High aggression overtakes, Albono. High aggression overtakes. Keep off the high risk curbs though, buddy. And the same for you, please. Albono is absolutely caning it. What's Danny Rick got in the tank here? That's fine. Avoid your high risk curbs for a couple of laps, mate. You're good. That's one of his overtakes done. What are you capable of here, Danny Rick? Can you pull a podium out of this? 2 seconds a lap quicker. What can you do, Albono? Steinwick just skinned him. Round the outside, down into La Source and Eau Rouge. Wow. I think third might be the best we can do here for Danny Rick. What's Albono got in the tank? Two seconds a lap is what he's got in the tank. I think it might just be a little bit too little too late for Albono here. It's right on edge.
Priority managed tyres now.
Consolidate, Danny Rick. You're not going for the win. Albono, however, very much is.
Can't use the overtake.
I think Alonso may have turned up the wick here. Yeah, I think it's just a little bit too little too late for Albono. Regardless, a cracking race.
Flag is out. P2.
P2, P3. We'll take that. That'll take us above Merck.
Alex Albon, put it in.
Danny Rick getting a fastest lap by a mile. P7 and P8 in the driver's standings. And P4. We've got no right to be there. Wait a minute. Because we did pit stops, and because others didn't, we got DHL points. Ha 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 ha! Brilliant. $3.5 million in the bank. We'll take that. Hello there. Mid-season board report. They've got to be happy with this, like. Right, we got a problem with the cars. So, front wing, replace. Underfloor, replace. Side pods. Doesn't actually matter. Because we've got new ones. So we're actually going to drop some high speed here for acceleration, which is fine. It's time for some more development of parts. So, why not? When's the next? Next ATR ferry is in 35 days. Interesting. Well, for next ATR period in 35 days, I'm going to develop some side pods then. Okay. Let's do that. Yeah, we know about all those problems. That's fine. So, calendar. Scouting, manufacturing, that's all good. So, pace short runs, just to remember, gives us cornering, braking, accuracy. Fine. On Bono, pace short runs, cornering, braking, accuracy. What's the other one? Adaptability. Yeah. Cornering, braking, accuracy. Which I'm fine with. I'm fine with all that. Back to the calendar, actually. Could potentially do with another underfloor. Right, calendar. So wheel gun will give us .44. Whereas if we went balanced and wheel gun. Yeah, that's fine. Let's do that. And then we'll go for pit stop time later. Okay. So Diego Tondi's not interested, and that's fine. Let's go to scouting for a technical chief. No. So you basically got all these guys that are not interested. Dirk de Veer, however, is. And I do want to bring him in. I do. Thank you. main. Let's try that. Do I want to sponsor Christian Mansell? Well, how good is he? ₹59 rated. He's not as good as other drivers. Like, I'd sponsor him. He's decent. Or him. That's not what the sponsor thing I want. All cars, contracts. Nope. Nope. Finance? No. Scouting. Oh. You know what, for the sake of... I'll sponsor him, why not? Let's see what happens. So we've got some more research complete and then a design complete, which is nice. Next ATR period is 26 days. So there's basically no effect on the rear wing. No effect really on the underfloor. It's all chassis, front wing, and side pods. So I think we go suspension. That's what we do. Okay. Design complete. Well, you know what that means. They're not going to be ready for Zandvoort. Which is a shame. We'll make four of them. So, we, oh my. Okay. Now, I could be wrong, but we've just given ourselves the fastest car on the grid. Effectively. Right, so what are we short of? Could do with another chassis. We need more front wings, to be honest. We'll have another three front wings. For now. Don't need any new rear wings. Probably do with another side pod underfloor. Not going to hurt that one. Plenty of suspension parts. So we'll have another side pod. Why not? So we got 2 mil in the bank. And as far as the cars are concerned, we have now lost medium speed, but we are much faster in slow speed. Oh, absolute insanity. What horrific mistakes have I made here? How long? 10 days. I mean, to be fair, the only thing that gets lost is, airflow sensitivity is really important, though. Let's do that, then. Oh, actually, no, airflow sensitivity isn't important. We'll expect for two cars to make Q2 and one to make Q3. A guarantee slot for finish position of both cars in the top 10. And a guarantee slot qualifying position streak of two cars in the top 12. Okay. I'd call that a productive race from last weekend. Last weekend, from today. Today's race was productive. Far more so than we expected. We're going to be pushing big for next year's car now. We don't need to develop this year's anymore. We've already gone past our past our objective and then some. There's no way that Haas are catching us. Might we be able to get Williams a win this season? Let's see. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to follow and subscribe. And like and all that stuff. Comment on the video while you're at it. Cheers.